So, you know the score. Vegas is very picky about what video files it will let you import. Either the video track doesn't work, or the audio track doesn't work, or you can't get it to import at all. This is one such example I've got. This video file. Vegas happily accepts the video track, but there's no corresponding audio track here because it doesn't recognize the audio format. It doesn't have the right codecs. And you've probably seen elsewhere, there are various ways around this, including giving Vegas the proper codecs for decompressing all the tracks in the file. Or some people prefer to download virtual dub and do it that way, but you really don't need to. Most people have VLC player, and that's a pretty good converter. In this instance, we don't even need to convert the entire video, we just need to rip the audio from the original source. So if we open our file in VLC, you'll see it happily plays the audio, but not the video. And that's the only bit we need anyway. So, what we're going to do is convert or rip the audio from this video track. But before we do it, make sure you haven't got loop selected or loop one track. Because if you do, when you try to convert this to an audio track, it will just keep overwriting in an endless loop. It's a bit of a glitch in VLC, really. But you can get around it. Make sure that's not selected. And go to Media, Convert Save. Drag your video file into this area. Drop down box here, click on convert. Convert selected there. Our profile, if you had neither the video or the audio being importable into Vegas, you could pick one of these, but we only need the audio, so we'll just pick CD quality audio, that's WAV. Our container is WAV. Video we don't want, so we make sure this is unselected. Audio we do want, so make sure that is selected. The highest bitrate we can do through VLC is 512. And our sample rate, the source audio for this was 48 kilohertz, so we'll go for that. When we pick our path, make sure when we change this to whatever name it gives us, make sure it's not the same as the file name that we're ripping it from. Because quite often it defaults to the same file name as you're using. If I'd left it at untitled 10.avi, when I click start, I would not have ripped the audio from it. I would have just overwritten the track and lost it forever. So if I had no copy of it, it's gone. So make sure, very important, you change that to the proper file extension. Click start, and that's it done. I can see it now in my browser here. So I just drag this onto the Vegas timeline, and now I have my audio for that video. You will notice quite often though, because the top file is measured in frames and the bottom file is measured in samples, that they don't quite line up. It might be different for you, but I found if you just line up the end of these two files together, and then, okay, I've lost one frame there. It's not too much, is it? Line those up and then drag this to the same length. And zoom out. If you click on one of them, then hold down Control and click on the other and press G. That now groups these together permanently in your timeline. So you can treat it like a normal video event that had its own audio track. So this is a way you can get around Vegas being fussy about codecs and you don't have to download anything extra. Most people already have VLC player. And you don't have to convert the whole thing. In this instance, we just wanted the audio track, and it's much quicker than converting the entire file. So I hope that helps. It makes life a lot simpler. Okay, take care.